What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Greg. Go crazy, go crazy. Yes, we back here with another video. Now, as you can see, before you do anything, go and hit that like, subscribe, and turn on the post notification bells for your boy. You know, we still out here grinding, and the grind ain't gonna never stop. Now, as you can see by the title and the thumbnail, I came to the stage at 3 in the morning. You know, it was my first time ever playing Sage. I was just up late and I was bored, so I was like, man, forget it. You know, I ain't got nothing else to do. Let's come to the stage. Let's see how toxic the stage is at 3 a.m. And not just the stage, we came to the 1v1 court. Now, y'all know how crazy this 1v1 court get in every 2K. Y'all know every 2K, the 1v1 court in the stage is ran by post course. So you gotta be on your game if you come to the stage and come to the 1v1 court. And it's 3 in the morning. Y'all know the later it get, the more the sweats play. Like, come on now. Like, this was crazy. But as you can see right now, you see I'm end up cooking him. You see I go, you know, right past him with the easy dunk. Now the score is 4-0. Now, right now, I'm looking unguardable at 3 in the morning. I mean, boy, when I tell you I was going to get a bucket, I was going to get a bucket. I ain't care about none of that. I ain't care about none of his defense, nothing that crazy. See him trying to clamp me. Look, I step back, green bean. Yes, sir, in his mitt, boy. Come on now. Now, I was trying my best not to give him the ball, because on this 1v1 court in the stage, it is make it, take it. Now, if you go into the market on Next Gen in 2K22, that is not make it, take it. So I had to adjust to it being make it, take it again, because I was like, oh, this ain't make it, take it. So now I realize, oh yeah, I really can't mess up, because I'm not trying to give him the ball back. Like, come on now. Now, as you can see right now, the score is 9-11. Now, you see me going right past him getting an easy dunk. Now, I'm really just getting every dunk I can, because they really not trying to give me space to shoot. Now, you see I'm hitting with a little misdirection move. If you don't know how to do that move, I made a YouTube video on it. Go check it out. It's on my channel. I posted that video maybe like 2 weeks ago, 2 or 3 weeks ago. But yeah, man, anyway, go check that video out. It teaches you how to do that little between the legs move you seen me do. Yeah, I made a whole tutorial on how to do that move. But yeah, you need to check that move out for me. And yeah, go on and leave a subscribe. I mean, go on and leave a like on that video too, just to show some support. Now you see me cooking him. I'm going right past him for the layup. Now you see he just jumping for joy. I don't know why he jumping for joy. Now you see me on momentum, snatching back, trying to get open. Now look, I go to the rim. Now look, I see I can't do this. 3 seconds left. I hit him with a spin move. He end up jumping and I get the layup off. Now the score is 17-0. I hit him with a little jazz up, hit a little, tried to get a little and one layup, but it didn't work out like that. But it's all right though, you know what I'm talking about. So he ends up hit me with a step back and ends up fading. Now I haven't seen anyone take faders in the mid-range since they was overpowered in 2K19 on the twos court. If you play 2K19, you know what I'm talking about when they do this fader, because that's all they used to do. That's all I used to do too. I used to hit the faders too, because I used to like shooting the faders in 2K19. That's when they was fun. I ain't even gonna lie, they fun in this game too. I just gotta learn how to shoot the faders. But you know, I will learn how to shoot them eventually. But you see, he ends up taking a stupid fadeaway, which just cost him the game, and he don't even know it. You did. Now you see me. You think he got good defense on me, but he really don't. You see, I'm going right back past him. Hey, now the score is 4-19, and it's almost over with. All I need to do is score a 2, and that's ball game. Now you see me cooking up ISO and trying to do what I do. Cooking him. I mean, I'm trying to get open. He's not falling for none of my moves. I don't know why, but hey man, that's how you see him with a little move. Go right past him. Hey, easy dunk. Now I end that game 4-21. Now I'm not gonna lie, in these next couple of gameplays, it's crazy. Like, remember when I was telling y'all them toxic 1v1 court? Look, here go right here. Look who I'm facing. I'm facing a two-way facilitator. Like, come on now. At 3 o'clock in the morning, a center like this, like, come on now. I ain't even gonna lie, I really thought I lost this game. I just knew I lost this game, because I just knew it was up with, because once you face a post score, bro, you just might as well just give up, because that's what it is. Because you know 2K, they never patch post hooks. They have never patched them since they've been in the game. You know, really, since people started doing them in 17, 2K has never patched them. They've been overpowered every single year. Y'all remember, even in this game on current gen, post hooks was so crazy that you could post hook from the 3-point line. But besides that point, hold up, Green Bean. But yeah, like I was previously saying, on 2K22 current gen, you could post hook from the 3-point line and it would count as a 3-pointer. I'm glad they patched it, but they still didn't patch post hooks completely to the point where they're not overpowered. Like, it's supposed to be a balance between post hooking, but it's never been a balance on 2K. You could jump at a post score and they'll still get like a slightly contest. And I don't know why 2K never fixes it, but hey, there ain't nothing we can do about it. We just got to keep going through it, man. I mean, they'll fix it someday, hopefully. I mean, we didn't think this game was going to be this decent, but hey, they made the game decent this year, actually. You know, it's playable. But besides that, you know, right now the score is 5-4. Now I'm trying to do whatever I can to get right past. Now you see me going for the dunk on him? Yes, sir. Now I ain't even going to lie, I did not expect to get that dunk off, because usually when I'm out of stamina and I try to do a dunk like that, 2K usually makes me they change my whole animation every time. Like, I don't even know why they changed my animation, but hey, I ain't nothing I can do about that. Now you see me, I end up shooting a stupid mid-range. I did not think he was going to contest that fast, because you know, sometimes centers, they don't contest that quick, but I'm slowly learning that some centers can on this game. Man, I don't know why, because I'm a whole guard. Like, how is a center catching up to a guard? Don't make no sense, but yeah, look, this is what I was talking about. He just bullying me in the paint. I didn't think I was going to get the ball back, but luckily, my player has Hall of Fame pickpocket. Boy, when I tell you that pickpocket came in clutch, boy, I mean, it came in clutch. Now, you see me cooking. Right now, the score is 6-7. I'm doing whatever I can, trying to get up. I end up shooting a mid-range of my jump shot and end up missing, but hey, I just missed it. Ain't nothing I can do about that. Right now, you see the score is 6-7, and he going right back in the post. You see he talking to me in game chat, too. I ain't even hear what he was saying. I would have liked to hear what Buddy was saying. I wish I could record what he was saying in game chat, because I know he was probably talking crazy, because that's what they usually do in game chat, especially in the stage. They be talking crazy, boy, just for no reason. Like, calm down, man. I'm just here to have fun, and you trying to do all that. Now, you see me end up pulling up from the 3-point corner, Green Bean. Yes, sir. Now you see right now the score is 8-10, and I'm still cooking. But right now he did predict my move right there, but you can't stop me. I ain't gonna lie, I'ma still cook you. That's just what I do. You feel me? It's just what I do. You know, I just be cooking people like him. Look, he jumping for joy. Stay on your feet. Now pulling up again, Green Bean. Come on now, stay on your feet, center. Stay on your feet. Come on now. Now the score 8-15. Now I could have took that, but I said no, because I'm not. He's not gonna block me and get the ball back. You gotta play. You gotta really try to play as smart as you can on the 1v1 court. You can't make really no mistakes. I'm lucky I got the ball back this much. Now you see me going to the rim, getting an easy dunk on him because he can't keep up with me. Thank you. Right now, the score is 8-17. I'm going right past him, making the score 8-19. I'm doing whatever I can to end this game. I'm not trying to take no crazy threes, no show off for the video, none of that. It's time to end these games. Now you see me going right past him, and he ends up getting the block on me, and he ends up getting the ball again. Now, usually, when it's 10-19 and the post score has the ball, it's usually game. But thankful for my Hall of Fame defense, he picked up the ball and then he got it right back. That's really a travel. I don't even know how he didn't even get that. And he ended up taking the layup over me, and he ends up getting a goaltending call. Like, how did I goaltend on a 7-foot center? That don't even make sense. But thankfully, my steal got me the steal back, and I won because of the dunk. Just like that. And just like that, the toxic post score is off the court at 3 a.m. Now, this will be the final gameplay of this video. Now, this was really my first gameplay, but I had to throw those other gameplays in there, you know, because those was the really cooked sessions. This is really the warm-up gameplay, if I'm being honest. I put him last because he really wasn't even worth the time, you did. But, you know, I still got my dub and beat him, and I'm going to post my dub because my dub is a dub. What are you going to do? He ain't going to do nothing. Now, this is when I realized that, hey, it get crazy in the morning because you never know who you're going to play. I just played a sweat center somebody else. Now you see me, I'm cooking him. I hit the step back green bean for the midi. I be trying to tell people, man, but if you don't believe me, man, mid ranges are the best shots really in the game. Those are the shots that really determine who the best players is. If you really check, like, if you notice, all the comp guards and all the nice people have a good mid-range crab game. If you can master the mid-range in any 2K, man, you will be a beast. Everybody can shoot threes, but a lot of people do not think of the mid-range game. I'm telling you, bro, it's a slept-on game. Mid-ranges is what really get the easy points. You don't got to draw to no rim. If you crab them enough times for a mid-range and you get open and you be cooking them in the midi, they're going to respect your mid-range. And as soon as they respect your mid-range, you pull that three. Then they're going to be like, oh, yeah, he cold. But anyway, that's besides the point. Now, you see right now, he can't really do nothing. You see, I got him, boy. I'm out here shaking and baking him, boy. You see, he don't know what to do. I'm going right past him for the easy dunk. Yes, sir. Now, the score is 6-0. He don't know what to do guarding me. I ain't even going to lie. I was cooking, boy. Even though it was my first game early in the morning, I was cooking him. Now you see me, I'm trying to get open, trying to do what I do. Right now, he like he got me in the box. I ain't even gonna lie. So I end up stepping back, waiting for him. Now look, he really want me to shoot the ball. And I end up shooting the mid-range, green bean. Like I was just telling you, that mid-range is a cold game to learn if you're trying to be nice at 2K. Now you see me hit him with a hezzy, a easy dunk. Now the score is 10-0. All I need to do is get 11 more points and it's over for him. I don't know why, but look, he ends up ripping me because of my silver unpluckable. And look, he getting up jumping. Get that out of here, man. What he thought this was? Give me that. Come on now. I told you, man, my players got defense. I really don't like players that don't have defense because it just looks terrible and it makes my play. It's not even my play style. My play style is majority playmaker, majority defense. Little bit of shooting, little bit of finishing. That's what I do. That's me personally. Now other people, they don't really care for that, but me, I'm heavy on the defense. If my build ain't got defense, I really don't want to play with it. I play with a build with no defense really, but I really don't want to. That's why I'm a droid. I just like playing lockdown because that's just like my play style. That's why I got light takeover on this player. Now you see me cooking him, going right past him, going to the rim for another easy dunk. Like I said, man, when you on the 1v1 court at 3 in the morning, you do whatever you gotta do to get that win. I don't care what nobody say. As long as you get that dub, man, it don't even matter at the end of the day, man. You feel me? You dig? Now you see me stepping back, trying to get open. It looked like he got me in the box. Now look, I should have shot that. I should have shot that shot. But I end up stepping back and shooting another shot and get scared. Like, why your my player ducking? Bro, what you scared of, bro? The air? What is you scared of? Come on now. Now you see me jumping for joy. He ends up getting an easy layup on me. I ain't gonna lie. I was flying like Michael Jordan in the air at that moment, boy. Like, that was crazy. But yeah, as you can see right now, he ends up pulling up and he can't shoot. Thank you. I'm so glad he can't shoot. So you see me going right past him, hey, with the easy dunk. The score is 14-12. All I need is 7 points to finish him off. That's all I need. Now you see me hitting with a hezzy, trying to get over. Now you see how 2K almost made me do a pull-up shot right there. Now I don't like that animation, bro. I promise you I don't like it. I don't know why they be doing that. I have one stop and go. I don't know why, but hey, they gotta fix that. But that's besides the point. As you can see right now, the score is 16-2. I'm hitting him with a little hezzy between the legs. You see, I'm trying to cook him, do what I do. I end up stepping back. I could have shot that shot. If my player had a higher three-pointer, I would shoot a lot more. I just don't be trusting it because sometimes they be giving me very earlys and very lates. That's why I don't be trusting the three sometimes. But it'll be all right. You see, I end up getting the layup, and now the score is 18-2. Going right past him. Hey! Yes, sir. Now the score is 2-20. Now all I gotta do is score a layup to get this bum off my court. And I'm telling you, man, this 3 a.m. going in the stage at 3 a.m. ain't no joke. Now you see me hitting with a little spin move. Hey, easy. Yeah, man. That's how my 3 a.m. gameplay went, man. Come to the stage at 3 a.m. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe if you're new. Share it with your family, and I'm out.